गुड आफ्टरनून स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू सिग्नल्स एंड सिस्टम ऑनलाइन वीडियो लेक्चर सीरीज। वी हैव बीन डिस्कसिंग द फर्स्ट यूनिट इन विच इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव स्टडीड द एलिमेंटरी सिग्नल्स। एक्चुअली इन द एलिमेंटरी सिग्नल्स वी हैव द फाइव टाइप्स ऑफ एलिमेंटरी सिग्नल्स इन विच इन द लास्ट क्लास वी हैव डिस्कस द थ्री एलिमेंटरी सिग्नल्स। एनीवे the remaining two signals will be discussed in the coming classes. In this class I am going to discuss the operation on signals by reviewing the last class, that is elementary signals. Elementary signals, which are very very useful to study the analysis of a system, are to realize or to construct some complex signals, these elementary signals are very very important. Elementary signals plays very very important role in studying the behavior of some systems, and these also very important to construct or to realize some complex signals. In the last class I have explained the elementary signals with some definitions and the graphical representations. There are six elementary signals are there, in which in the last class we have discussed the three. First one is unit step signal, and second is a ramp signal, and third is impulse signal. After reviewing these three signals, we are going to discuss the another important topic, that is operations on signals. From the elementary signals we can expect the one short answer question, it is a damn sure question, and from the operations on signals we can expect the one long answer question. So if you are good at this elementary signals and as well as operation on signals, at least you can get the 7 to 10 marks. So I hope I am very very clear. I am going to reviewing the elementary signal. That elementary signals are unit step signals, ramp signals, and impulse signal. Unit means one. Step means instantaneously it moves from off state to on state. Off state is 0, on state is 1, so that it is named as unit step signal. Unit step signal means unit means 1, and it instantaneously moves from off state to on state, whose amplitude is 0 or 1 only, only two amplitudes. This type of signal is named as unit step signal. And we know that unit step signal is denoted with u of t. If it is a continuous time signal, it is denoted with u of t. If it is a discrete time signal, it is denoted with u of n. Here t and in case of discrete time signal, that is n, both are independent variable. But here it is a t, it is a continuous time varying signal, and whereas n is an integer. So mathematically we can define this unit step signal. Unit step signal, that is u of t, whose amplitude will be only two things only, either 1 or 0 only. 1 is for all the t values which is greater than or is equals to 0. That means what? Here u of t is a continuous time signal whose name is unit step signal, and here t is an independent variable. When the t is greater than or is equals to 0, whose amplitude is 1, otherwise it is 0. That means what? For t less than 0. This is the mathematical definition of unit step signal. By making use of the mathematical definition, you can go with the graphical representation of this particular unit step signal. We know that independent variable must be taken on x-axis. That independent variable is t. If it is t, this will be the minus t. and this is 0. If you see the mathematical definition of this unit step signal, it is having t greater than or is equals to 0. That means what? From here to here, it is t greater than or is equals to 0. And from here to negative manner, it is t less than 0. Then u of t is equals to 1 for t greater than or is equals to 0. That means here to here, t greater than 0. Here to here, t is less than 0. So that u of t is equals to 1. So that independent variable is plotted on x-axis. Then the amplitude of the signal, that is u of t, must be plotted on the y-axis. So this is the graphical representation of any signal. You have to remember the point is that independent variable must be taken on x-axis and the amplitude of the signal must be taken on y-axis. This is, if it is u of t, and this will be the minus u of t. But anyway, we are not going to see this one because according to the definition, we are having only u of t, not minus u of t. Then I am going with the graphical representation of this particular signal, that is nothing but a unit step signal. Now I am going with the unit step signal. Definition from the mathematical definition, yeah, u of t is equals to 1 for t greater than or is equals to 0. From here onwards, t is greater than or is equals to 0. So that for t greater than or is equals to 0, whose amplitude is 1. So that assume that this amplitude is 1 here. At t is equals to 0, whose amplitude is 0, whose amplitude is 1. Now this amplitude is 1. At t is equals to 0, amplitude is 1. As the t is increasing in positive, that t greater than is equals to 0, that amplitude again is going to be 1 only. For all the positive values of t, for all the positive values of t, the amplitude is 1. For all the negative values of t, the amplitude is 0. This is the unit step signal. Now you can see this is completely, seems to be a step only now. It is instantaneously moving from off state to on state, and it seems to be a step only. It seems to be a step, and this type of signal is named as unit step signal. Unit step signal. Mathematical definition is very simple. U of t is equals to 1 for all the values of t greater than or is equals to 0, and it is 0 for t less than 0. This amplitude is what? It is a 0. Here too, as the t value is increasing in negative manner, that amplitude remains same, that is 0 only. If the t value is positive, that amplitude is 1. And if you see clearly, that signal is continuous with respect to the time. As the time is going, and the signal is also there. For every instant of time, there is a signal. This type of signal is named as it is a continuous time signal, and this particular signal name is unit step signal. By applying this unit step signal to any system as an input, we will study the behavior of that particular system, how quickly it will move from the off state to on state, how quickly the system will respond to this signal to move from the on off state to on state. This is the use of that particular unit step signal. This is a unit step signal. Coming to the next one, ramp signal. Ramp signal is also very, very important signal in analysis of some type of systems or in realizing some complex signals. Ramp signal is nothing but, it is a signal which linearly increases with respect to the independent variable. We know that if it is continuous time signal, independent variable is t. If it is a discrete time signal, that independent variable is n. So that we are going to define this ramp signal is in continuous time signal only. That continuous time signal, ramp signal is denoted with r, and if it is continuous time signal, that is r of t. Definition is very simple. Ramp signal is a one in which amplitude is linearly increases with respect to the independent variable. Here the independent variable is what? It is a time, and whereas the r of t is nothing but it is a signal and it is a amplitude of that particular signal. So that mathematically we can define this R of t, if it is R of t, that is called as continuous time ramp signal, and it is linearly increasing signal with respect to the independent variable. So that for all the positive values of t, it linearly increases. R of t is equals to simply R only. R of t is equals to simply, you can call it is t only. That means what? Whatever we will have the t, and that is only the amplitude of the signal for t greater than or is equals to 0. That means what? We know that independent variable must be taken on x-axis and the amplitude of the signal must be taken on y-axis. This is R of t and this is t, and this will be the minus t. And this will be the minus R of t. Anyway, we don't require this minus R of t. So here, R of t is nothing but t only for t greater than or is equals to 0. From here to here, whatever the t value is there, that is only the amplitude. So that as the t value is increasing, then the amplitude of the signal is also increases. So that just now I have given the description of this ramp signal. Ramp signal is a one in which the amplitude is linearly increases with respect to the independent variable. If it is a continuous time, we have represented that is R of t is equals to t for t greater than 0. Otherwise, it is 0 for t less than 0. This part is what? This part is t greater than or is equals to 0, and this part is t less than 0. Then I am going with the one particular analysis now. See this one? I am keeping at t is equals to 0, R of 0 is 0. That means what? At t is equals to 0, R of 0 also 0. Keep at t is equals to 1. At t is equals to 1, R of 1 is also 1. So that this amplitude is here. T is equals to 2, amplitude is 2. T is equals to 3, amplitude is 3. Like that it is happening. As the t value is increasing, the amplitude of the signal is also linearly increasing. This type of signal is named as, it is a ramp signal. Just now we discussed this is a ramp signal and it is a linearly increasing signal with respect to the independent variable in the positive values of t. Then what about the negative values of t? For the negative values of t, whose amplitude is 0, so that it is, this is the linearly increasing signal with respect to the t, and this is the 0 for t less than 0. This is t less than 0 only, whose amplitude is 0. This type of signal is named as, it is a ramp signal. It is also very, very useful in realization of some complex signals. This is a ramp signal. And the next one, if you wanted to define this ramp signal in the discrete time also, you can go with R of n is equals to n for n greater than or equals to 0, or 0 for n less than 0. That means what? In case of continuous time signal, at every instant of time, there is a signal. In case of positive values of t, there is a signal. In case of negative values of t, there is a signal. At every instant of time, there is a signal, so that it is nothing but it is a continuous time signal. Whereas in discrete time signal, we can have the signal at some discrete instant of time only. Here we can have. In between these two points, we cannot have any signal. And that type of signal is named as a discrete time signal. Anyway, the discrete time signal will be discussed in the fourth unit. The third important signal, that is nothing but impulse signal. Impulse signal plays very, very important role in the analysis of some complex systems. Impulse signal is a signal whose amplitude is 0 at all the values of t, except t is equals to 0. This is very, very important. Impulse signal is a one in which amplitude is 0 at every value of t, except t is equals to 0, this type of signal is named as impulse signal. If you want to define the impulse signal in a continuous time, and it is del of t. Del of t, u of t is nothing but what? It is unit step signal. R of t is nothing but it is a ramp signal. Impulse signal is nothing but it is del of t. Del of t is nothing but del of t. Del of t whose amplitude is 0 at all the values of t. At all the values of t. That means what? Except t is equals to 0, remaining all the values, that is 0. At t not equals to 0, that means what? Except this part, at every value of t whose amplitude is 0 only. But at t is equals to 0, at t is equals to 0, that is having the signal whose amplitude is infinite. Whose amplitude is infinite, and we can represent this type of signal in graphical manner by making use of the graphical representation. We know that x-axis used to represent the independent variable, that is t. If it is t, and this will be the minus t, and this will be the del of t, and this will be minus del of t. Then we are going with what now? Impulse signal. Impulse signal, by making use of the mathematical representation, we can plot the graphical representation of that signal. At t is not equals to 0, that means what? Except this part, except at this point, that signal amplitude is 0. So that this is 0 and this is also 0. But at t is equals to 0, whose amplitude is infinity. At t is equals to 0 means this is at t is equals to 0, whose amplitude is infinity. So we can represent the signal is like this. This is infinity. And this type of signals are named as, this type of signal is named as impulse signal. These are the very, very important signal. From these three signals, one signal directly asked in the exam for 2 or 3 marks. So I have discussed the one short answer question. I'm going to talk about the one long answer question in this video now. So another topic I'm going to discuss in this video, that is nothing but operations on signal. For example, I'm going with the one particular example. Here, this is a system, assume that this is a system to which I have applied the sinusoidal signal, and it is an input, and due to some manipulations inside the system, the output of the system is given as a triangular wave like this. That means what? This is a system, it has taken the input is sinusoidal, and inside a system there are so many manipulations has been done on the sinusoidal signal, and at the output of the system we are getting the some triangular wave. That means what? Signal has been going with the many manipulations inside the system. Signal may go through some manipulations, and that means nothing but we are going to apply some operations on signal to get the required output. To get the required output, system is going to perform some operations on signals. Due to that operations on signals, signal may going to transferred into the another form of signal. That means what? Indirectly, we are applying some actions on the signal. We are applying, the system has been applying some actions on the signal, and that particular thing is named as operations on signals. Here, operations on signals, nothing but by applying the one particular signal as an input for a particular system, that signal may go through various manipulations, which is actions initiated by the system, such that output of that system may not be the equal to the input signal. That means signal may going to have some manipulations. Some actions has done on the signal so that we can get the new type of signal. For example, assume that here I have applied the signal, that is x of t. I have applied the signal is x of t. Which type of signal? It is continuous time signal. This signal applied as an input for the system, so that output I got the another signal, that is y of t. Both are continuous time only, continuous time in nature, but this x of t is one particular signal and y of t is another particular signal. Why I have got the y of t? Because on this input signal, some operations has been done on that particular signal, so that it has manipulated into the new signal, and that signal we named as y of t, that is output. That means what? The system inside, the system is going to initiate some operations on the input signal, or that input signal may undergo with the various operations, various manipulations, such that it will produce the y of t. That y of t is nothing but it is a new output. So in short we can say that when we process a signal, the signal may undergo several manipulations involving in the independent variable or the magnitude of the signal. That means what? Whenever the signal is going through various manipulations, either independent variable may changes. Independent variable means what? Or the time independent variable may changes, or amplitude of the signal may changes. In this topic, we are going to talk about how the independent variable is going to be changes. The point is very, very clear that x of t is a one particular signal. It is applied as an input for the system, so that it is going to manipulated with the several operations, so that either t is going to be affected or x of t is totally going to be affected. So anyway, if t affected or x of t is also affected, then that is going to have the new type of signal, that is called y of t. If independent variable is going through some manipulations, we can have the three types of operations on the signal. That signal operations are, there are three types. One is called, it is time shifting operation. That means what? By making use of time shifting operation, we can shift the signal from one location to another location. Next one is time reversal operation. Time reversal operation. That means what? We have the signal is in one particular quadrant, and by applying the time reversal operation, we can get the same signal in the opposite quadrant. That means what? If we have the audio signal, if we play in a reverse direction, that is the example for the time reversal signal. Next one is a time scaling operation. Third one is a time scaling operation. Time scaling nothing but what? Playing a signal is in the slow motion, or playing a video in a fast forward motion, that is called, it is a time scaling. There are three operations are there on a elementary signals or any signal. First one is a time shifting. That means by making use of this time signal, time shifting operation, we can shift the signal from one location to another location. And coming to here, time reversal, that means what? We can get the same signal in the opposite quadrant. Time scaling, we can have the signal is in the stretched version, or it is in the compressed version. So anyway, with the example, we are going to study all these three operations on the signal: time shifting, time reversal, time scaling. So I am going to explain the introduction of this all these three. So if the independent variable here, if the independent variable is manipulated while the signal processing, that means what? Here we have applied the x of t. And inside the system, if the independent variable, that is t is manipulated, then we can have the three operations on the signals. First one is what? Time shifting. Next, second one is time scaling. And the third one is a time inversion or a time reversal. So from these three, any one topic or all the three can be asked for the 10 marks. So that from these three, one question will be asked for 10 marks. That means what? By giving a signal, apply the time shifting, time reversal and time scaling. Then what will be the new type of signal? That type of question will be asked in the exam. I hope I am very, very clear. introduction, that is the operations on signal. We are having a system. This is a system to which we are applying the signal, that is XFT, so that this inside the system, this signal is going to have some manipulation. It has to undergo with the many manipulations. Due to that manipulation, output of that system is the new signal, that is YFT. This new signal is due to the three operations. First operation is what? Time shifting. Second operation is time reversal. Third operation is time scaling. In this class, I am going to talk about the time shifting operation of a signal. Time shifting operation of a signal. In short, I will explain the time shifting operation of a signal. For example, this is a system. Assume that it is a system. In the introduction to the signals and system, I have given the definition for the system. System is a physical entity which is a meaningful interconnection of various discrete components. So that it is a system to which we have been applying the input. This is an input. Input signal, I am assuming that is X of T. X of T is a which type of signal? It is a continuous time signal. X of T, it is a continuous time signal. X of N, is it a discrete time signal? Next one, if this is X of T and it has undergoes with the many manipulations inside the system, so that system output will be Y of T. Now X of T is one particular signal, Y of T is another particular signal. But the here key point is that both are continuous time signal only. That means what? Amplitude and the independent variable, both are continuous in nature. But X of T is not equals to Y of T. X of T is not equals to Y of T. X of T is an input signal, Y of T is an output signal. After going through the many manipulations inside the system, the new signal has provided by the system, that signal is Y of T. Now I am defining the Y of T. Y of T, what is Y of T? Y of T is equals to, Y of T is equals to, where we got the Y of T? By using the input signal only, we got the Y of T. Y of T is nothing but X of T. It is an input signal, but it has gone through some manipulations on the independent variable, so that I can call it is X of plus or minus capital T. Where capital T is a finite time constant value. That means what? Actually, if it is Y of T is equals to simply X of T, that simply the signal is passing, this system is simply passing the input signal only. There is no new output at the output side. So, but output is what? Y of T is nothing but some operations performed on independent variable on the input side. So that is nothing but, it is Y of T is equals to X of T plus or minus T. If X of T is manipulated with plus or minus T, and this type of operation is named as a time shifting operation. And from this we can write the two cases now. From this we can write the two cases, that is Y of T is equals to I got Y of T at the output side. I have X of T, T is an independent variable, and the capital T is a finite time constant, and if it is plus T, we can have. And second case, we can have Y of T is equals to X of T minus T. That means what? Here Y of T is equals to, we have, that is X of T plus some finite value. And here Y of T is equals to X of T minus some finite value. And this type of signal is named as delayed signal. It is a delayed, this type of signal is named as a advanced signal. and this type of signal is named as it is delayed signal. So here the conclusion is nothing but by employing the time shifting operation, by employing the time shifting operation on one particular signal, the resultant will be either advanced signal or delayed signal. Either advanced signal or a delayed signal. The point is very, very clear. We have the XFT, it is applied as input for a system so that independent variable has to go through some manipulation so that it has provided the new output. That is what Y of T. Y of T is equals to what we have? X of T plus R minus T, where capital T is a finite time constant. So from this we can have the two equations. Y of T is equals to X of T plus T, or Y of T is equals to X of T minus T. And if we have the signal Y of T is equals to X of T plus T, that is called advanced signal. If we are having Y of T is equals to X of T minus T, that is called delayed signal. So that I am going to explain with the one example, and with that everything will be clear, I hope. So assume that this is X of T. Without applying any operation, this is X of T. And if it is X of T, and this will be the T, and this will be the minus T. So that I am going with one signal now. That signal is there from here to here. This is a signal, assume. This is a signal. Now I am going with the one particular signal, that is about Y of T is equals to, Y of T is equals to, what is the formula we have? Y of T is equals, first one go, X of T plus capital T. T plus capital T means what? It will be the advanced signal. That means what? My signal is there from minus 1 to plus 1. And whose amplitude is A? Assume that X of T is there, that is from minus 1 to plus 1. By applying some operation, time shifting operation, that I got Y of T is equals to X of T plus T. That is nothing but advanced signal. So that it is going to get advanced to this signal. So that advanced to this signal means this is the original signal. Advanced to this signal means it will shift left side. So that I can get the same signal in advance to the original signal. This is advanced to the original signal. This is the signal I got now. This is amplitude is same. And again, it is shifted by the, it is shifted left side by T units, so that you can call this here to here it is shifted, so that this is nothing but it is T units. And coming to the another case, we have Y of T is equals to, we have X of T minus capital T. If T is advanced signal, it is shifted left side, and this is a, we are saying it is a delayed signal. Delayed signal means it shifted right side. So that signal will be the same signal, will shift right side now. Same signal will shift right side with the again same unit, that units are T seconds, capital T seconds. This signal is what? It is delayed signal. Delayed to what? Delayed to X of T. And this signal is advanced signal. That advanced signal to the X of T. This is a advanced to X of T. This is a delay to X of T. That means what? By applying the time shifting operation, by applying the time shifting operation, we can get the either advanced signal or delayed signal. Here the key point is noted that even in the advanced signal and the delayed signal, the none of the characteristics of the signal is not going to be changed. No characteristics is changing by applying the time shifting operation. That means what? Amplitude is remain same only. The span of the signal remains same only. Here the span of the signal to minus 1 to 1 it is 2. And here also it is 2 and it is 2. That means what? By applying the time shifting operation, none of the characteristics of the original signal will not be changed. And the second one, the time span of that signal is going to be is not going to be changed. So that by applying the time shifting operation on any signal, that may be continuous time signal or discrete time signal, that we can get the either advanced signal to the original input signal or a delayed signal to the original input signal. So that conclusion of the time shifting by employing the time shifting operation, that is we can get the y of t is equals to what, x of t plus or minus capital T. And by making use of these, we can get the two signal, that is either advanced signal. Advanced signal means what? Signal will shift. Signal will shift left side. Signal will shift left side. Delayed signal means what? Signal will shift right side. These are the conclusions. In the next class, I am going to talk about the another type of operation, that is time reversal operation. And in the next class when I am going to talk about the time scaling operation, and we are going to study some various examples in the case of time shifting, time scaling, time reversal, such that we can expect the one long answer question by long answer question from the topic of the basic operations on the signals. If you are good at the three operations on the signals, that is time shifting, time scaling, time reversal, we can easily expect 110 marks question. If you are good at these three operations, you can easily get the 10 marks from the first unit. So thank you students, don't waste the time, don't go outside, be in the home, then the situation is too bad outside. And try to write the notes from the we shared videos. And if you have any doubts, you can text me or you can call me anytime. Thank you, students.